Welcome to our community. Susie Thomas with you this morning. We welcome Wendy Lichtenwalter from the Mercy Service League. Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, first of all, some people might be saying, what is Mercy Service League? So let's start there, Wendy. What is this organization?
We are a group that does fundraising for the hospital. Our efforts are directed by the Mercy Development Foundation. And the proceeds of our fundraisers go to support various projects within the hospital. Last year, we completed our pledge for the 5B renovation, which is it's an orthopedic floor and also a step-down unit for folks who are needing observation after a surgery, whether it be a one-day surgery or a more extensive piece. And they have training facilities pre-op and post-op for folks in there. It just opened 2 weeks ago on Monday on Martin Luther King Day, and it's a huge improvement over what was there before.
Mm. Can you talk about the improvements? What was and what is now?
They have occupational therapy and physical therapy in all hospitals, but it used to be a room that was kind of multi-purpose. But they have got state-of-the-art patient rooms now where they have the lifts for people. I mean, if you've had orthopedic surgery, you can't really get yourself from your gurney to your bed to your chair. So they have patient lifts there in every room. The rooms were sponsored by many of the local doctors and people who participate in general philanthropy through the hospital. But they also... before you have your surgery, there are important things to know so that you don't overextend yourself. And so they have pre-op teaching and post-op teaching, but it's all in one unit with dedicated nurses' stations. And there's an enormous amount of paperwork that has to be done in hospitals nowadays. So they have special areas for the computers for charting in every single unit, and I'm sure every hospital, but at Mercy they certainly do, so that the doctors can do their charting right there. And, you know, things don't get forgotten and meds don't get mistaken. And everyone is right there at that time to understand what that patient wants and needs, and you know what is appropriate. So it's a pretty amazing concept, and the fact that they're trying to get it to more private rooms as well. You know, hospitals used to have wards or semi-private rooms, but people really prefer a private room now. So this has really increased the hospital's ability to have private rooms.
That does sound so much nicer. I think sometimes we forget that getting ready for a surgery is a lot. There's more to it than just your mental state. That's very important. But so this would walk us through physically what we need to do to prepare our bodies before surgery and then how to recoup afterwards with post-operative, that time of life, so that little period of time. Yes, am I hearing this right?
Yes. And then they also, patients often stay a day or two or maybe even three, but then they go to a rehab facility, but they've already gotten the basis of what they need. The people in the hospital have been able to assess, evaluate, recommend, you know, after the surgery, did it really work? You know, I mean, did we get all the proper outcomes? And so that when the person goes to a rehab facility, they have a better chance of succeeding.
Right. We're so impressed with what happens. Are you talking about like something like Woodlawn or something like that where people
care
move on?
Does that stuff too.
Exactly. Yeah. Yes. Boy, those places are just amazing. But I think just hearing you say 1, 2, or 3 days after surgery, my response, and I know you're not a doctor, but is that enough?
I had a friend who just had arthroscopic knee surgery, and 3 hours after the surgery, she was walking down the hall. I saw the video. I was amazed. But, you know, I mean, we have so many more ideas now about what healthy is. And this was a healthy woman who, you know, plays tennis and does other stuff like that. And, you know, she didn't have a lot of other compromising situations, so it was appropriate for her to get up and start walking. So, you know, lying in bed is not necessarily, like, it's comforting, but it's not necessarily helpful. So
that's a really good point. And and I think also, if we stay healthy in every other way, when a disease does come along, we've got all much better equipment physically to battle it and to get back on our feet quickly.
Yep.
You know, I think also listening to you talk, you forget how important volunteers are to the whole medical care process. You're not a doctor. You're not a nurse. You have an education background, a little bit of science and biology in you. You do know what you're talking about. You know the dance. But what drew you to working at the hospital? And my goodness, where would we be with our hospitals without volunteers?
Yeah. I joined Mercy Service League when it was Timken Mercy Service League many years ago. Then the hospital was sold and things changed and the name changed and whatnot. But I used to work in the live flowers where we put bows on the plants and take them up to the gift shop. But then I ended up going back to work, so I didn't work with them for quite a while. I just have found that it's a very friendly, welcoming group.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Mercy Hospital does not turn anyone away ever for an inability to pay.
Let's back up there and say that again, because I think with the Affordable Care Act and people, can I afford insurance? Can I not afford insurance? Put insurance aside. Let's talk about medical care
right. And
say what you just said again.
The hospital will never turn a person away from care for lack of ability to pay. It's on the walls, in the emergency room, in the patient rooms, and, you know, it's the Catholic hospital. They're doing God's work. They are committed to that. Mm-hmm. They do outreach in the community to look for places that are underserved, where people really need health care. And rather than, you know, being in their main building, they have gone out into the community, St. Paul's Square on the northeast end. They take their mobile mammogram unit out there. The last time you and I talked, I mentioned it could take an hour and a half bus ride for someone to get from the northeast end to Mercy, or I'm sure to Altman. It's about the same mm-hmm. distance of a ride. But an hour and a half, you're sick. Do you have that much time? And it could take that amount of time to walk there as well. So it's just a difficult situation. So Mercy has reached out into areas of Maslin, in, you know, Dover, Hartville, Northeast End. There's something on the Southeast End is also in mm-hmm. play.
Mm-hmm.
Because folks need closer care. It's like
yes.
a medical desert. You know, we all hear of food deserts,
yes.
but there are medical deserts in this country too. And Canton has fewer of them because of some of the things that Mercy has done.
That's so wonderful. Well, I know a little biased here. My father-in-law was a surgeon there forever. And their kitchen at Christmas time was packed with fruit baskets and wonderful baked goods from people who had not been able to pay their hospital bill or their medical bill. And these were thank yous.
Yeah.
And it was just always really amazing to see that all coming in, that they were mm-hmm. paying in the way that they could pay. And we were the better for it because we got to enjoy all those treats.
Yeah.
You've got a great event coming up, the Super Bowl, and spell it for us.
S-O-U-P, Super Bowl, because it's a soup tasting competition. It is coming up on Sunday, January 28th. The doors open at 4 o'clock. We're there till 7 o'clock. We have 10 different restaurants and three high school culinary classes that are going to be making our desserts. It's going to be held this year at the McKinley Eagles Club, which is on Monticello Avenue between Woodlawn and Perry Drive, but pretty much close to the corner of Monticello and Perry.
Mm-hmm. Oh, this just sounds fun. Do you know how many soups? What kinds of soups are going to be?
10 different soups at this point. We have everything from lobster bisque to chicken, Amish chicken corn chowder, to stuffed pepper soup, to cheeseburger soup.
Whoa.
Cabbage potato sausage. I think we have a zuppa toscana, which is Italian sausage and potatoes and kale. And you get to taste as many as you want, and then you get to vote on your favorite soup. There's a trophy.
Who's making the soup?
We have Cosmos, Tim's Tavern, Metz Culinary, which is the hospital catering. We have Arrowhead Country Club, Cheese and Crackers Deli. I don't want to forget anyone. Dog Days.
And more. Is there
yes.
is there a website where
yes.
we can? Okay,
yeah.
let's see
the
all of
hospital,
them.
The hospital website, if you go to Mercy. Canton.org and look at events. You can see what's going on there.
Mercy Canton. www.ecosystemcollective.org and look up events.
Yes, mm-hmm. Slash events.
Great. And that is coming up this Sunday. What time does it all get started?
We start at 4 o'clock. Our soups will be there at 3. Oh, and we have Bella Sara, too, pepperoni rolls. They donate half of our pepperoni rolls. So and they actually were one of the winners of the competition.
That's so fun. How long have you been doing this?
This is our fifth year. And we added a cornhole competition last year. So if you've got nothing better to do, and there's no football games this Sunday, unless you count the Pro Bowl, but, you know, that's not a big fan thing. It's just a enjoyment thing. So, and you'll be home in time to watch the game anyway. So.
There you go. That's right. And what on these cold winter days, what is better than some awesome soup?
Soup and pepperoni rolls and desserts. And the high school culinary classes really have fun competing for this. It's going to be Perry, Jackson and McKinley culinary classes. I just talked to the McKinley chef this morning.
That's so awesome. And they are doing the desserts?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Do we know what kinds of desserts they're going to have?
I haven't heard Jackson's final selection, but they're having a chocolate cheesecake from McKinley, and Perry is doing a lemon blueberry cake. So, and they're tasting sizes, so it's not like you're committing a huge amount. I mean, you get a small bowl of soup, so you can, 32 ounces is a quart, and if you eat restaurant all from 10 different restaurants, that's 30 ounces right there. So,
Well, we're going to fill up.
Yeah.
Well, you had me a chocolate cheesecake, so never mind. We will be there for you with bells. The cost for this to be able to attend is?
It's $30 for the tickets, which is really low for a fundraiser. But since the soups are donated and the desserts are pretty much donated, we don't have a lot of overhead for this. And this is the first time we've done it at the McKinley Eagles Airy. But it's, zero entry. You don't have to climb any steps. There's the parking lot is right outside the door. And it's a very nice room. Lots of room for 300 people.
Is it possible? I know you can get 300 in there.
Yeah.
Is it possible to get soup to go?
Yes. At the end of the evening, whatever soups are left, we sell for $5 a quart. And if you've priced any soups in the restaurants or the supermarkets, like $5 is a bowl, not a quart. So at the end of the evening, when we've given everyone a chance to taste, we have the opportunity to buy a $5. You get the container, and then you take it to whatever soup vendor, and you can fill that up. And the rest of the soups at the end of the day are donated to a soup kitchen. So,
Oh, how perfect. Bit of a gamble. Do you have any leftovers at the end of the day?
We have run out of Tim's Tavern clam chowder the last 2 years, but they're not bringing clam chowder this year. They decided to go to their shrimp and lobster bisque instead.
Oh,
that's the other restaurant. I'm sorry. Tim's.
Tim's. Yeah. And lobster bisque.
Yeah.
Okay.
So,
which I already know how good that is. That is good stuff. Okay. Well, I'm getting pretty excited. $30 a person.
Right.
And matter your age.
Beverages, too. It includes unlimited beverages as well. And this is not a fancy fundraiser. Please wear your football jersey or your team jersey from your school or something casual, because it's just for fun. And who wants to play cornhole in high heels in a dress?
Well, that's right. Okay. Oh, you're doing this right, for sure. And it's something for the whole family,
right,
yes?
Right, right. Definitely. Children under 5 are free.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah.
Even better. Because I know some under 5-year-olds who can eat their way through a good bowl of soup. So that's pretty good. All right. Again, all of the details. This is taking place this Sunday, January 28th, starting at
4 p.m.
And we go to the McKinley Eagles. Where is that located?
Monticello Avenue at the corner of Perry Drive in Monticello. There's a driveway on that side, too.
How do we get tickets? Do you sell them online or do we buy them from a friend?
You can actually buy them at the door. But by going to CantonMercy.org/events, that's where the tickets are as well.
Is it Canton Mercy or MercyCanton.org?
I'm sorry. It's Canton Mercy.
Okay.
.org.
CantonMercy.org. And
/events,
and you can buy them online.
Yes.
Awesome. All right. We're going to take a short break here. We'll be back with Wendy Lichtenwalter after these words. You're listening to Our Community.